Tonight, as we celebrate Shabbat, we will also commemorate Kristallnacht, the Night of Broken Glass, an event which took place on November 9th, 1938. This night and days that followed marks the very darkness that was to befall European Jewry, known to us as the Holocaust. We begin tonight with a brief nigun based on the second verse of Psalm 22, which asks, "My God, why have you forsaken me?" But then we will continue with the meditative song, which gives us hope through love. I will build this world from love. Olam chesed ibaneh. Ya la 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 la. Olam chesed ibaneh. Ya la la. I will build this world from love. Ya la 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 la, ya la 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 la. I will build this world from love. Ya la 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 la, ya la 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 la.
Ya la 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 la.
And if we build this world from love, ya la 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 la, ya la 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 la. And if we build this world from love, ya la 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 la, ya la 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 la. And if we build this world from love, ya la 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 la, ya la 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 la. And if we build this world from love, ya la 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 la, ya la 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 la. Then God will build this world from love. Ya la 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 la, ya la 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 la. Then God will build this world from love. Ya la 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 la, ya la 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 la. Then God will build this world from love. Ya la 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 la, ya la 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 la. Then God will build this world from love. Ya la 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 la, ya la 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 la. Olam chesed yibane, ya la 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 la, ya la 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 la. Olam chesed yibane, ya la 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 la, ya la la.
Shabbat Shalom. We're so happy to have you here at our services for Erev Shabbat at Temple Emanu-El. And we would like to read from a little bit of Rabbi Lord Jonathan Sachs this evening, who is of blessed memory, who has just passed. While we read Parshat Hayesara, where we learn of Rebecca and her meet cute, her well scene with Isaac's servant Eliezer at the well. And if you recall, Rebecca gives Eliezer so much water, so much so that she even waters all of his camels, going back and forth, drawing water for his parched soul, his parched body. And Rabbi Jonathan Sachs of blessed memory said that the beauty of Shabbat in particular is that it allows us to stop and get to the things in our lives that aren't necessarily the most urgent, but are the most important. And this is where we water our souls during this time of Shabbat. And when we do this, we come out ready to face a new week, whatever it may hold for us, both the joys and the challenges. And we are strong and we are watered. And so with this, for all of us, maybe we can take a look at how taking those small sips of water, just recognizing the beauty of each prayer that we have during this Shabbat. I see Cantor Novick taking a small sip of water. Thank you for modeling that. That was not scripted. We just see these prayers and these moments of Shabbat and seeing each other on the screen, seeing the smiles, the chats of Shabbat Shalom and welcome from wherever we are in the world. And let that water replenish our souls as we welcome the Shekinah. We continue with Shalom Alechem on page 142.
Shalom Aleichem, Malachei HaSharet, Malachei Elyon, Mimelech, Malachei HaMlachim, HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Noachem Neshalom, Malachei HaShalom, Malachei Eyyom. Mimelech, Malachei HaMlachim, HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Seitchem Neshalom, Malachei HaShalom, Malachei Eyyon. Mimelech, Malachei HaMlachim, HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Ochem Shalom, Malachei HaShalom, Malachei Eyyon. Mimelech, Malachei HaMlachim, HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Seitchem. Seitchem Shalom, Malachei HaShalom, Malachei Eyyon. Mimelech, Malachei HaMlachim, HaKadosh Baruch Hu.
We continue with Lahadodi on page 138, verses 1, 2, 5, and 9. And we ask if you are able to rise at verse 9, the final verse, to welcome the Shekinah from wherever in your home or wherever you are, the Shekinah will enter. And pray with us.
Yeah, no, 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 Shabbat Kala. Yai la 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 yai la 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 la. Hine Shabbat Nikabela Itoreri. Itoreri.
Before we light our Shabbat candles, a prayer to share together. Dear God, may it be so that when we look into the heart, our eyes have the kindness and reverence of candlelight. The searching of our minds be equal to the oblique crevices and corners where the mystery continues to dwell, glimmering in fugitive light. When we become false and lost, we pray that the severe noon light would cast our shadow clear. When we love, that the dawn light would lighten our feet upon the waters. As we grow old, that twilight would illuminate treasure in the fields of memory. And when we come to search for you, God, let us be first robed in night, put on the mind of morning, to feel the rush of light, spread slowly inside the color of stillness of a found world. We continue on page 121.
Shall shine.
We continue on page 144 for the Hatzi Kaddish.
Yitkadavit kadashimei rabba Be'olimod v'rachiruti Be'yomech machute Be'chayichonu v'yomechon U'v'chayedachol bit Yisrael Ba'agala, ba'agala U'v'izman karif Imeru, amen. Yeheshmera b'mevorach le'olam olal me'almaya yitvarach. Yitvarach v'yishtabach v'yitvar v'yitroman v'yitnaseh v'yitadar v'yitaleh V'italal sh'medikucha b'richu le'ela min kol birchata v'shirata tushbechata v'nechemata damiran be'alma v'imeru Amen.
Please rise. Baruch ata Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, asher bidvaro ma'ariv aravim, bechokma poteach sharim, uvitvuna mishane itim, umachalif et hazmanim, umsader et hakochavim, b'mishmor tehem barkia kirtzono, bore yom v'layla, golel or mipnei hoshech, behoshech mipnei or, umavir yom umei v'layla, Umavdil ben yom, vain laila, Adonai Sevaot shamo. El hai vikayam, tamid yinlok, alenu le'olam v'ed. Baruch ata Adonai, hama'ariv aravim.
Benismo
Ach, bedivrei Torotecha, uv mitzvotecha, leolam vaed. Ki hem chayenu, veorech yameinu, ulfahem nege yomam valayla, yege yomam valayla. Ve'ahavat chal tasir, mimenu le'olamim, baruch ata Adonai, ohev amo Yisrael. Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad, Baruch Shem Kevod Malchut.
You may be seated.
Le'ahavta et Adonai Elohecha bechol levavcha uvechol nafshecha uvechol meodecha vehayu hadvarim ha'ele asher anochi mitzavecha Hayom al vavecha, veshinantam levanecha, vedibarta baham, veshiftecha habvetecha, uvlechtecha vaderech, uvshochbecha, uvkumecha, ukshartam lehot al yadecha, vehayulatotavot, Bein einecha uchtavtam al mezuzot beitecha uvisharecha lema'an tizkeruhu va'asitem et kol mitzvotai ve'hiyitem kedoshim le'Eloheichem ani Adonai Eloheichem Asher hotzehiti etchem me'eretz Mitzrayim lihiyot lachem l'Elohim ani Adonai Eloheichem emet.
Standing on the parted shores of history, we still believe what we were taught before we ever stood at Sinai's foot. That wherever we go, it is eternally Egypt, that there is a better place, a promised land, that the winding way to that promise passes through the wilderness, that there is no way to get from here to there except by joining hands, marching together. Before we pray the Micha Mocha on page 158, I'd just like to take a moment to appreciate the act of being together tonight during this Shabbat, as we are also able to listen to one of our own congregants share some beautiful words of her own Torah, and know that we're always in hand together, walking to the promised land.
Kamucha nedar bakodesh. Guide my steps and help me find my way. I need your shelter now. Rock me in your arms and guide my steps and help me make this day a song of praise to you. Rock me in your arms and guide my steps. Ufrosanenu sulkat shlomecha. Ufrosanenu sulkat shlomecha. Oh, guide my steps and help me find my way. I need your shelter now. Rock me in your arms and guide my steps and help me make this day a song of praise to you. Rock me in your arms and guide my steps. Oh, guide my steps. Oh, guide my steps.
Continue our service with the Amidah. Please rise.
Adonai sefatai tivtach ufi yagiti hilatecha. Adonai, open up my lips that my mouth may declare your praise. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu Elohei avoteinu v'imoteinu Elohei Abraham, Elohei Yitzchak, Elohei Yaakov, Elohei Sarah, Elohei Rivka, Elohei Rachel, Elohei Leah, Ha'el Hagadol Hagibor Vanora, El Elyon, Gomel Chasadim Tovim, V'konei hakol, v'zocher chaste avot v'imahot, u'mevi geula livnei v'nehem, lema'an shemo v'ahava. Melech ozer u'moshiach u'magen, baruch atah Adonai, magen Avraham,
Bezrat Tzara, Ata Gibor Laolam Adonai, Mechayeh HaKol Ata Rab Lehoshia, Mashif HaRuach Umorit HaGashem, Mechakel Chaim Bechesed, Mechayeh HaKol Berachamim Rabim, Somech noflim verofei cholim umatir asurim umekayem emunato lishenei afar michamocha baal givurot umidomelach Melech mimit umechaye umatzmiach Yeshua v'ne'emanata lehachayot hakol Baruch atah Adonai mechaye hakol atah kadosh v'shimcha kadosh u'kadoshim b'chol yom Yahallelu chasela Baruch atah Adonai Ha'el HaKadosh.
We take the next few moments of silent prayer. When you're done praying, I invite you to be seated.
Ose shalom bimroma Uyase shalom aleinu Behakol Yisrael Beimeru Amen Ose shalom bimromam Uyase shalom aleinu Shalom bimromam Uyaseh shalom aleinu Ve'hakol Yisrael Bimiru Amen Shalom bimromam Uyaseh shalom aleinu Ve'al kol Yisrael Bimru Yimru Amen
During our silent prayer, our thoughts may have turned to a loved one or a close friend that needs a bit of healing of mind, body, or spirit. Our synagogue community thinks of Zalman Bendina, Gabby Kraft Buckman, Susan Klein, Summer Curter, Susan Robb, Linda Rabino, Arlene Furman, Neil Silverman, Linda Fleischer, Larry Maslow, Mason Rockmore, Martin Ostroff, Don Hirsch, Pearl Weitzman, Aaron Taylor, Perry Shellman, Sharon Meese, Rabbi Rob Nesenchuk, Emily Tucker, Andy Skatorius Diori, Sharon Zinni, Joyce Kagan, Gloria Ostrocker, Ina Botdevil Draymond, Scott Goldberg, Rena Goslin, Emil Vogel, Kathy Murphy, Betsy Miller, Mark Goldstein, Aviva Khanna, Mary Ann Stahl, Allison Tischler, Dean Rossi, Stephen Brundage, Betty Moore, Madison Mosher, Robin Fisher Solis, Phyllis Brown, Shmuel Hava Ba'itzak Vassara, Shirley Rosenberg, Stephen Wasser, Aaron Ben Malka. If you are thinking of someone, I invite you to write their name in the chat box. David Lazar, Michelle Glisten, Helene Miller, Bruce Shachnoff. God who heals all flesh, God who lives in each breath, strengthen your people Israel and all who dwell on your earth at this time. Give us blessing and peace of mind. Grant our hearts strength to stand in our places and to stand at this moment of radical change. Provide a complete healing of body and spirit to all of the sick and to all who are suffering from COVID-19 as well. And grant to all those who are attending to their needs, nurses, doctors, family, and friends, the power to comfort and heal. When we are alone, may we find times to be at one with you. While we are withdrawn, may we still be with our friends and family, enabling us to take steps to bring help and assistance in all the ways that we can. Please, God, please heal us all. And together we say, amen. And on the Shabbat, while we remember those who are sick and those who are in pain, we also want to recognize the sweetness of this past week, and that we do that with Kiddush. We do that with by recognizing the sweetness of Shabbat. If you have something that really special happened to you this past week, a birthday, an anniversary, a new job, something small or something big, we invite you to share it in the chat box so we can acknowledge the sweetness of this Shabbat with you as well. And I invite all of you to rise.
Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, borei peri hagafen.
Amen.
Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, asher kedeshanu b'mitzvotav, beratzavanu. B'shabbat kodesho, be'ahava uv'ratzon, in chilanu zikaron lema'ase bereshit ki hu yom techila lemikrae kodesh zecher litziat mitzrayim ki vanu Beotanu kidashta mikol ha'amim v'shabbat kodshecha be'ahava uv'ratzon hinchaltanu baruch ata Adonai Mekadesh HaShabbat. Amen. L'chaim.
L'chaim. And so sweetness happens throughout this week, including just this Shabbat when Amanda White got into another college. We should tell people that if they come to services, their children get into college. Art shared with us that his daughter, Deborah, is due with her, the second child in May, Basha'a Tova, in good time. We see that the meshes are back in New Jersey, safely from Texas. We're glad that you are joining us. And Jenny Tenenbaum said, within hours of asking for help for our refugee family, so many generous community members stepped up, and we've been able to furnish someone's new apartment. So thank you. That's the epitome of good. A sweet thing, Jenny. And thank you for your leadership with the Westfields Fun Club and continuing to support our refugee families. Please be seated. As Cantor Novick began our service, we are tonight remembering Kristallnacht, the 82nd anniversary of Kristallnacht. And so in just a few moments, we'll get to hear from Phyllis Buxbaum, who will share a story of her husband and his Holocaust story and legacy that he has enlisted on the rest of his children and the rest of his family. But before Phyllis speaks, we share a blessing for this moment. Tzor Yisrael, Rock of Israel. As we mark the 82nd anniversary of Kristallnacht, we thank you for the strength and endurance and spirit of hope that has enabled the Jewish people to survive, revive, and thrive after the Shoah. May our recollection of the terrors of the night of broken glass, the burning synagogues, homes, and workplaces, the women, men, and children harassed, assaulted, and killed, remind us of our sacred responsibility to nurture and nourish Jewish life today. Eternal One and foundation of all existence, as we remember the murder of 6 million Jews by the Nazis and the destruction of tens of thousands of Jewish communities, may we reaffirm our obligation as Jews to challenge anti-Semitism, racism, xenophobia, homophobia, transphobia, persecution and bigotry of all kinds, and to engage in tikkun olam, the repairing of the world. And let us all say, amen. I turn our service over to Phyllis as she shares some words with us this evening.
Okay. Thank you. Can you hear me? Am I? Okay, thank you, Rabbi Presnick, for inviting me to share Saul's story. I always feel very humble about talking about the Holocaust because I'm not a survivor and I didn't suffer, but Saul's story should be told for the future generations and he's not here to tell it. He had been asked several times to talk about his war experiences. He declined, saying, "I admire those who can speak about it, I can't." But once when our children were in high school and college, he did relent and he spoke at a Yom HaShoah commemoration here. And so I have included some of his words in my remarks. I met Saul in 1953. He was a grad student at MIT. I was a freshman at Simmons. We met at a Hallel dance. Very good thing to know. He was a plucky, energetic college student, full of life, enjoying school, a good tennis player, a very good bridge player. And as we got to know each other, I learned a bit about his war experiences and the losses he had suffered. But mostly I learned he just wanted to live a normal life and not dwell on the past. He didn't want people making a big thing about it. Those were his words. Saul was born in Stray, Poland in 1929 into an Orthodox, prosperous family, joining two older sisters. His father and grandfather were jewelers in Stray. They were big makas in town. And in Saul's words, "I went to shul with my father and grandfather every Shabbos. They had seats by the Eastern Wall. I didn't know the significance of a seat by the Eastern Wall until I saw Fiddler on the Roof in Broadway." Saul's parents had many siblings and Saul had about 45 first cousins. So remember that number, 45. His father was the eldest of several children. And during the 1920s, two sisters of his father and a brother emigrated to the US. And Saul's sister, Dorothy, an older sister, told me
that she begged their father to leave. Because of the anti-Semitism, she couldn't have the education she wanted. She had wanted to be an architect, and now she was working and living in a factory, which had actually ultimately helped save her life. But their father, the eldest, was responsible for his aging parents, for running the family business, tending the grave sites, and he wouldn't leave. In September 1941, the Germans invaded Stray and removed all the Jewish men from their homes. Saul was 11. He never saw his father again. His mother soon learned that the men had been shot and buried in the woods outside of Stray. And after the war, Saul always observed his father's and mother's yahrzeit on September 14th, the last day that he saw his father. Again, Saul's words, "The Germans stayed until there was nothing left of the Jewish community in the Stray ghetto. During the long days of the ghetto, there was just one goal, one desire, one overriding ambition, to outlive Hitler. Only a few realized that goal. Saul's sister told me that once during that time, when they were eating their diet of rotten potatoes, Saul said, about 12 years old, 'I wish Hitler felt like I do now.' And in the spring of 1943, all the other Jews of Stray, including his mother, Saul, age 13, and his sister Yudka, 18, were rounded up to be put on a train to a concentration camp. His mother urged them to run away, but his sister wouldn't leave her, and Saul never saw them again. Saul did manage to escape, and somehow barefoot, he jumped on a freight train and made his way to Warsaw. Saul scouted the area. He saw a house that looked unkempt, and he asked the woman who lived there if he could live there, and in return, he would work around the house and the yard. That safe haven didn't last very long. He overheard a neighbor asking the woman, 'How do you know that boy's not Jewish?' And pretty soon a Nazi came, and he came and questioned Saul, who had to drop his pants, show his circumcision. The Nazi would have taken Saul away, but the woman, the nice woman, bribed the Nazi with money and or jewelry, and the Nazi left without Saul. However, the woman then told Saul, 'I can't let you stay here anymore.' Again on the streets, he somehow got false papers stating that he was a Catholic with the Catholic name of Jan Jambitsky. He found refuge in a Catholic orphanage where he said they were kind to him, asked no questions, and he was treated like a nice Polish boy called Janik. He recited mass every week and became an altar boy. And after the war, for a while, at the drop of a hat, he would begin to chant the Paternoster. It had saved his life. There are many unknowns to this story, many holes in the story, since Saul said, in his words, 'I am not going to dwell at length about events which I might prefer not to remember. I don't think there's much value in doing that.' He had lost contact with his sister, Dorothy, who had been saved by living in the factory where she worked. She had also made her way to Warsaw and was working as a nanny, living as a Catholic with false papers at the home of her employers. Saul had left the orphanage and he got a job walking dogs in a park in Warsaw. Dorothy and he had not seen each other for about a year and a half, and of course Saul had changed a lot. A friend of Dorothy saw a boy in the park that she thought might be Saul walking the dogs. She gave Dorothy the information. He walked at this park every day at a certain time. And Dorothy was able to go there. She found that boy. She walked carefully behind him. And when she thought it was safe to get close, she got up and said, and whispered, 'Saul.' And he turned around. And that's how they were united for a while. At some point, Saul met a young woman who was working for the Polish resistance. Her parents, not Jewish, let Saul live with them while he was being trained to fight in the resistance. He was 15 and being trained to shoot. Fortunately, the war ended before he saw much fighting. Years later, Dorothy still remembered that address where Saul had lived during that short time in Warsaw. And when my granddaughter Elena and I were in Warsaw during the March of the Living trip, we were able to walk by it and see that address. Saul's schooling, of course, had been disrupted by the war, but he said he learned Latin, I guess, at the orphanage, and that that had helped him learn English in later years. In Saul's own words, "Compared to the Jews who survived in the concentration camps, I had an easy life. I do not have a number tattooed on my forehead." However, one of the few things he told me was that there were days when he didn't know if he would live through the day. As for Dorothy, she was outed as a Jew towards the end of the war, and she spent about 2 months in a camp. She never would talk about it. When the Nazis left Warsaw in defeat, they of course burned the city. And when Dorothy was freed from the camp, she went back to the address where Saul had been living. There was nothing left, she said, but a doorpost. She stuck a note to the frame, hoping that Saul would return and find it. And he did. And they were reunited once again, this time for good. In Saul's own words, "When the war ended, I had a choice to make, to stay in Poland as a Pole or to resume my identity as a Jew. I did the latter, of course. After what had happened, it was simply unthinkable that I would not continue being Jewish. However, in gratitude to the religion that had helped save his life, he now had a middle name, Jan, his Polish name. And in the summer of 1946, he joined Dorothy and her new husband, Irving, also a Holocaust survivor, in Munich, where many of the survivors lived while waiting to immigrate somewhere and begin new lives." In Saul's own words, "In the fall of 1946, I found myself in Munich among Jews once again, and I decided for the first time since my father's presumed death some 5 years earlier to say Kaddish. And so I went to this makeshift shul on Yom Kippur Day to participate in the Yiska service. The shul was fairly small, very hot, very crowded. That was not so unusual, but there was something strange, something peculiar about the people in the shul. For one thing, there was almost an eerie silence prior to the beginning of the service. Can you imagine a Jewish crowd not talking? They just stood and waited, and I among them. I later realized why. They were strangers to each other. They came from all parts of Europe, from Poland, Hungary, Romania, and some from Germany, but nobody had belonged in Munich. We were not a congregation ready to pray as a congregation. Yet, just as the Hazan intoned the Yiska service, a true transformation took place. Suddenly, we all knew each other. We all knew why we were there. We all remembered. We became a congregation, a tightly knit congregation. You know, in one important sense, Hitler did us Jews a favor. Yes, he did mercilessly and ruthlessly destroy millions of us and try to eradicate our culture. But he also caused in those who survived, and I dare say, those not in Europe who only witnessed, a reawakening, a fierce strengthening of the Jewish spirit and identity. Let's continue to remember." With the help of the Canadian Jewish Congress, Saul came to Canada as an orphan under the age of 18. He described the ocean voyage as follows. He said it was a very rough journey crossing the North Atlantic in November, I think it was 1947. Almost everybody, all refugees were seasick except for three people, Saul and two other kids, and they went around and ate everyone else's food. Saul always saw the positive. The Canadian Jewish Congress had a wonderful program. For the years between 1946 and 48, they brought over war orphans. And Saul arrived in Halifax, Nova Scotia in November, not speaking a word of English, no formal education, and no official papers. the Canadians greeted these teens, welcomed them with proper papers and housing arrangements with families in Montreal. Saul was taken to Montreal, where he was taken in by a couple who had lost their son in the Royal Air Force during the war. They provided Saul with a safe and comfortable haven while he learned English, mainly, he said, by watching TV. He worked in a hat factory, and he obtained his high school equivalency degree all within a year. He said he knew he didn't want to spend the rest of his life packing hats. So back to the Canadian Jewish Congress, and with guidance counseling and a one-year scholarship, he entered McGill University. He distinguished himself with flying colors the first year and needed a scholarship for the remaining years. He liked math and thought he would be an accountant, but there was a full scholarship for a boy majoring in physics. It provided tuition, room, and board, and he said, "I couldn't afford to turn it down." In 1952, Saul graduated from McGill University, first in his physics class, and won the Ann Molson Gold Medal, one of McGill's top academic prizes. After earning a master's degree at McGill, he arrived at MIT as a grad student. That is where I met him, living his life with purpose and passion. Now, as you remember, I asked you to remember the number 45. That was the number of first cousins he and his sister were a part of. Only two survived, Saul and his sister Dorothy. While Saul did not want to dwell on the past, he said several times, "I take great satisfaction in having outlived Hitler and in the fact that my children and grandchildren are Jewish." So in Saul's own words, let us continue to remember.
Thank you so much for those words, sharing them with our congregation. And Saul's legacy is here tonight, as we know that your family is joining us from across the country, with you in Madison and in California, and I think Texas as well. And so we are so glad that the Buxbaum family is here, continuing on Saul's legacy. And so we are touched by your words as we remember Kristallnacht tonight, as well as Saul. Thank you.
We continue now with a prayer for our veterans. This past week, we celebrated and honored Veterans Day, and we encourage you to put the names of anyone you're thinking of during this prayer in our chat so we can hold them in honor and gratitude. God of compassion, God of dignity and strength, watch over our veterans in recognition of their loyal service to our nation. Bless them with wholeness and love. Shelter them. Heal their wounds. Comfort their hearts. And grant them peace. God of justice and truth, rock of our lives, bless our veterans, these men and women of courage and valor, with a deep and abiding understanding of profound gratitude. Protect them and their families from the loneliness and want they may have. Grant them lives of joy and bounty, and may their dedication and honor be remembered as a blessing from generation to generation. Blessed are you, protector and redeemer, our shield and our stronghold. We think of Harold Novick, Robert Koch, Jerome Tucker, Murray Weiss, and Art Salem, Stanford Lamp. Amen. Amen.
We continue our service with the words of Elenu on page 586. I invite you to rise.
Latet gedula leotzer breshit, shelo asanu kikoye aratzot, velo samanu kemishpechot adama, shelo samchel kenu kahem, vegoroleinu kechol hamonam, v'anachnu korim, u'mishtachavim u'modim, lifnei melech, malchei hamlachim, hakadosh baruch hu.
Please be seated, page 591. Rise up like the Son of God over all humanity, and cause light to go forth from all lands between the seas, and light up the universe with joy of wholeness, of freedom, and of peace.
Ve'ne'emar v'haya Adonai Lemelech al kol haaretz bayom ha'hu yiyeh Adonai echad u'shemo echad.
There are stars up above, so far away we only see their light, long, long after the star itself is gone. And so it is with the people that we loved. Their memories keep shining ever brightly, though their time with us is done. The stars that light up the darkest night, these are the nights that guide us. As we live our days, these are the ways we remember. And so tonight, as we remember those who have died in the Holocaust, as well as those who have died in this season and years past. If you are remembering a loved one, I invite you to write their name in the chat box, as well as your relationship with your loved one. We recall loved ones who have died in the last 30 days. David Bregman, husband of Nancy, father of Carol Gross. Lee Bumhung, uncle of rabbinic intern Becky J. Marjorie Feinberg, wife of Chet. Bernard Weinstein, husband of Terry. Sheldon Glickman, husband of Anne. Dennis Rodkin, father of Steve. Sheldon Reich, father of Lenore Argan. Mae Cohen, aunt of Susan Cohen. Barry Rose, stepfather of Lori Wendler. We also recall a loved one who has died but not yet buried, Shirley Shapiro, mother of Rick. We also remember the yard sites of our loved one's deaths. Janice Bloom, Maureen Bluestone, Morris Brown, Wendy Crown, Seymour Cummins, Cecile Ehrman, Shirley Essenfeld, William Fine, Betty Feldstein, Gordon Forgash, Bert Fox, Pamela Frank, Ben Geyer, Ethel Geller, Esther Glassman, Abraham Gollish, Sylvia Gottesman, Elaine Greenberg, Dorothy Groder, Robert Horner, Jesse Kaufman Jacobs, Norman Kaplan, Max Klein, David Klebanner, Ben Kogan, Samuel Kohel, Marian Landu, Elias Listman, Herman Lowenstein, Eva Markman, Sarah Miller, Murray Moskowitz, Isaac Mukamal, Rose Plisner, George Popper, Isaac Rabino, Martin Reich, Gail Robinson, Martin Rogoff, Harold Schwartz, Hortness Sedwin, Alan Sester, Ray Shapiro, Erwin Silberg, Rose Skolnick, Nathan Spivak, Stanley Tehel, Trudy Tripp, Nathan Trinan, Bernard Wasserman, Saul Weil, Bruce David Wiseman, Martha Wilson, Max Walkoff, Robert Zaharowitz, Sanders Zuckerman, and Private Harold Zweigbaum. We also remember Abraham Gollish, Kathy Seidler, May Cohen, David Klebanner. If you are remembering a loved one, I invite you to rise and unmute yourself as we say the words of Mourner's Kaddish together. I invite all of you to rise. Yikadal v'yikadash shemei rabah. Yamah divarach hirutei v'yamlik malchutei.
My L.
Amen. May the one who creates harmony on high bring peace to us and all who mourn, and comfort the bereaved, as together we say, amen.
Amen.
Please be seated. Before we turn to our closing song, just a few announcements before we wish everyone a Shabbat Shalom. First of all, thank you again to Phyllis for sharing those words, sharing the story of your beloved husband. We are richer in those stories and will now be a part of us. So thank you so much. We have a lot of upcoming events that you should check out, just a couple to highlight. Of course, our second wine tasting is this Sunday. If you want to be a part of it, I think you can still order the wine, but we hope that you join us. It was a great Sunday night last week. There are, the sisterhood I know is bringing in a clothing drive the next week, as well as Wednesday and Thursday, we are doing a turkey drive and a Thanksgiving fixings drive as well. Please drop it off between 3 and 5. We are looking for volunteers to help us bring all the food to JFS in Central New Jersey. We're also looking for volunteers to distribute the turkey at JFS next Sunday as well. So please join us for that. You can reserve your spot online. We are we're making sure that we are able to spread out. So we're only asking for a couple of volunteers for each shift. Anything else that I'm forgetting? Check your e-blast. And for actually next week, a very special Shabbat as well, as we celebrate our 6th adult benot mitzvah. They will be leading our congregation in prayer in words of Torah, as well as words of why they have decided to go on this journey. So we hope you join us next week at 6 p.m. To celebrate them. Cantor Novick, our closing song.
Eli, Eli. You'll see it on the screen. Eli, Eli, Shelo yigamel olam, achol v'hayam, rishru shel hamayim, berak hashamayim, the crowd.
Novick, thank you to Becky, and thank you to Gail and Joel for turning our pages. One last announcement, we have a new program called Chamishim. It's for empty nesters. You'll be, if you are fall into that category, you'll be getting an email about some exciting events that are coming up for you as well. Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom, everyone.
Phyllis, you were amazing.
Stay healthy.
Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom, everybody.
Thank you, Phyllis.
Phyllis, that was wonderful. Thank you so much.
Beautiful.
Thank you,
Phyllis. You did a wonderful job.
Thank you, Phyllis.
Becky, thank you.
Thank you. Fabulous.
Thank you, Mary.
Hi.
Give me a break.
Wonderful job, Phyllis. Hi, Phyllis. Oh, great job, Phyllis.
Thank you.
Hi, Janet. Hi,
Mary.
Did we miss it?
No. Great job. Inspiring story.
That was funny.
Beautiful. It's a real mitzvah to share it with people, I believe.
Thank you.
Beautiful.
It's a mitzvah to pray with you all.
My brother-in-law.
Hi, Janet.
He is now. Oh my God, it's so funny. It's Chuck and Jerry.
Okay. Phyllis, you're saying hi to people. Beautiful.
Oh, there's Jerry. Oh, there's Amy and the cat. I don't know who that is.
Thank you. Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom.
Shalom.
Beautiful.
I think we got
Phyllis, where's your family? Where's all your family from?
Where's Shira?